our biology session. So we are discussing our lesson, that is diversity in living things and their classification from the state board standard 6. From this lesson, already we have discussed in our previous video, we have discussed about the classification of plants. So in today's video, we will discuss about diversity and classification in animals. Okay, so yesterday also we have discussed about the diversity. What is meant by the diversity? Diversity means what? Variety. So like that, if we are having the variety in the plants, like that we are having the variety, or there is a diversity in the animals also. Okay, so today we'll discuss about the diversity and classification in animals. So if you have seen in your surrounding, then you can see the different type of the animals. So there are the so many different types of the animals are present around us. Some are living in our house also. If we talk about the house lizard, then it is crawling on the wall. If you have seen the butterfly, then the butterfly is having very nice wings. If you have seen the cat and dog, then they are also living around us. So in this way, there are the different animals are living surrounding us. But have you ever think that all these animals looks the same? All these animals are having the same body parts? Is it? No, all these animals are not having same body parts. The different animals are adapted, or these different animals develops the different body parts to live in their particular environment. Okay, so if we'll talk about the fish and if we'll talk about the cat, then both are so much different with each other. There are the drastic changes among the fish and the cat. Why? Because the fish is living in the water while the cat is living on the land. Okay, so their environment is different, and that is the reason their body parts are also different. Okay, so the animals are developed themselves to live in their particular environment. We are having the diversity, or there are the so much variety in the animals also. We can see the very small, very minute, or we will talk about the very small animals. For example, the amoeba. That amoeba we cannot see with our eyes. And on the other hand, we are having the very huge elephant, we are having the snake, we are having the fish, we are having the birds which are flying in the air, we are having different types of the monkeys are there, different types of the terrestrial animals are there. So in this way, there is a huge variety in the animals also. Okay, and these animals are having the different body parts to do the locomotion. In our previous lesson, we have already discussed about the locomotion. So animals are having the different body parts to do the locomotion. We can say that the animals are having the legs to do the locomotion. Also, they are having the eyes, they are having the pair of limbs, then they are having the neck region, then there is a torso region. So in this way, all these are the different body parts which are present in the animals. Okay, also these animals are having the different type of the systems in their body which are doing their works regularly or punctually. Like that we are having the digestive system, like that animals also having the digestive system. Okay, so in this way, different systems are there, and the different systems are doing their work along with their different organs. Okay, so different organs are there, different systems are there, but along with that, all these animals are having so much diversity among themselves. We are having the variety of the animals present on the earth. So in our previous lesson, that is what sources of food, we have discussed about the types of the animals depends on their feeding habits. Okay, so along with the animals, different animals are having the different types of the food, and to take that different types of the food, they are having the different types of the organs. Okay, so according to their feeding habits, the animals are divided into three categories that we know as what? Herbivores, carnivores, and we can say as what? Third one, omnivores. Okay, herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores, these are the three groups which are based on the feeding habits of an animal. So now what is meant by the herbivores? The animals, those who are having the green plants or the plants and their plants product, then that animals are called as what? Herbivores animal. What is meant by the carnivores? The carnivores means what? The animals, those who are eating the flesh of other animals. That animals are called as what? Carnivores. And the third one category is what? Omnivores. What is meant by the omnivores? The animals, those who are having the plant and plant products, and also they are having the flesh of other animals, then that animals are called as what? Omnivores. Okay, so see, these are the three categories, and their food is also different. So according to their food, their body structure is also different. If we say that the herbivores, then the herbivores are having the flat and the broad teeth, which helps them to chew the green leaves properly. Also, they are having the neck. With the help of that long neck, they can eat the leaves from the tree. Next one is that carnivorous. Carnivorous is eating the flesh of other animals. It means what? They are having the very strong and the sharp teeth that we are calling as what? Canines. Okay. And next one is what? Omnivorous. So, all these are the three categories of the animals on the basis of their food habits. Okay, so this is the first classification of the animals based on their feeding habit. Now we will see that there are the so much animals present on our earth. Some are there that we cannot see, and some are so much huge. Okay, so why we cannot see the some animals or some organism? For example, we can say that paramecium is there, amoeba is there. Why we cannot see to them? Because these animals are made up of only one cell. Okay, and what is meant by the cell? Cell is the structural and the functional unit of a living organism. Okay, so our body is having proper structure and having it is doing the different functions with the help of the cell. So the animals, those who are having only one cell, then that animals are called as what? Unicellular. What is meant by uni? Uni means one, and cellular means what? Cell. So the animals whose body is made up of only one cell, then that animals are called as what? Unicellular animals. While on the other hand, there are the certain animals which that animal's body is made up of what? So much cell, or that more cells are present in their body, and that animals are called as what? Multicellular. Multi means what? Many more. Okay, so that body of an organism contains the more number of the cells, then that animals are called as what? Multicellular animals. Okay, so on the basis on the number of the cells, the animals are get classified into two groups, that are unicellular and multicellular. What is mean by the unicellular? The animals, those who are having only one cell in their body, then that animals are called as unicellular animals. While the animals are having the so much cells in their body, then that animals are called as multicellular. Unicellular organisms, we can say that amoeba is there, paramecium is there, euglena is there. All these are what? Unicellular organisms. Next one, multicellular. We can say that so much animals are there. Ant is also the multicellular. Human being is also multicellular. Elephant is also multicellular. Cat, dog, so many are there which comes under what? Multicellular. And very important thing is that these unicellular organisms, we cannot see with our naked eyes. To observe them, we have to use the microscope. And that is the reason these unicellular organisms are also called as what? Microscopic organism. Okay, these unicellular organisms are also called as what? Microscopic organism. Next one, we will discuss about, as we know in our skeletal system, we have discussed about the vertebral column. What is it by the vertebral column? The chain of the bones which are present in our back region, it is called as what? Vertebral column. So on the basis of the presence of the vertebral column and the without vertebral column, the animals are again get classified into two categories, that are vertebrates and invertebrates. Now what is mean by vertebrates and the invertebrates? So the animals, those who are having the vertebral column, okay, so the animals which shows the presence of vertebral column in their body, then that animals are called as what? Vertebrates animal. While if there is an absence of the vertebral column, or if the animals doesn't have the vertebral column in their body, then that animals are called as what? Invertebrates. In means what? Absence. There is no presence of the vertebral column, then that animals are called as what? Invertebrates animal.
So if we'll talk about the examples of the vertebrates, then we can say that snake, birds, also we can say the human being, kangaroo, cat, dog, cow, buffalo, lion, all these are the animals, those who are having what? Vertebrate.
Okay, means what? They are having the backbone or they are having the vertebral column in them. While there are the certain animals, for example, we can say that cockroach is there, earthworm is there, snail is there, all these are the animals which lacks the, or there is an absence of vertebral column in their body, then that animals are called as what? Invertebrates. Vertebrates means what? Presence of the vertebral column, and invertebrates means what? Absence of invertebral column. Okay, so on the presence and the absence of the vertebral column, the animals are get classified into two groups, that are vertebrates and invertebrates. Now we move for the next classification of the animal, that is on the basis of mode of reproduction. So on the basis of the mode of the reproduction, animals are further divided into two categories, that are oviparous and viviparous. Now what is mean by oviparous? Okay, so you have seen the hen's egg. Okay, so from that hen's egg, if the hen will provide the warm to that egg, then after the some period of the time, from that hens the chicks will come out, the or the chicks will hatches out from the egg. It means what? The hen is giving the birth to the chicks with the help of the eggs. Okay, or we can say that there are the certain animals, those who are laying the eggs, and from that eggs their newborns or their new individuals are comes out, then that animals are called as what? Oviparous. Okay, what is mean by the oviparous? The animal, those who are laying the eggs, and from that eggs the new individuals come out, then that animals are called as oviparous animal. Okay, very easy to keep in the mind. OV. Okay, how is the shape of the egg? Oval shape. Okay, so in this way we can keep in the mind the oval shape egg. So the animals, those who are giving the birth to their new individual with the help of the eggs, that animals are called as what? Oviparous. Next one, on the other hand, we can say that there are the certain animals, those who are giving the birth to their young ones directly, then that animals are called as what? Viviparous animals. Okay, some animals are giving the birth to their young ones directly, we can say the cow, dog, kangaroo. Okay, also the human being, all these are the animals, those who are giving the birth to their young ones directly, then that animals are called as what? Viviparous. Okay, so in this way, on the mode of the reproduction, the animals are classified into two groups, that are oviparous and viviparous. Oviparous, those who are laying the eggs and newborns comes out, then it is called as oviparous. Viviparous, directly giving the birth to the young ones. Next one, we'll move for the next classification of the animal, that is on the basis of their habitat. Okay, so on the basis of their habitat, the animals are again get further classified into four groups. We can say that were terrestrial, aquatic, amphibian and aerial. Okay, so now what is meant by the terrestrial? Terrestrial means what? The animal, those who are spending or they are living on the, spending their more life or they are living on the land, then that animals are called as what? Terrestrial animals. We can say that tiger, lion, cat, dog, cow, buffalo, all these are the animals, those who are living on the land, then that animals are called as what? Terrestrial animals. Next one, there are the certain animals, those who are spending their whole life in the water or they are living in the water, then that animals are called as aquatic animals. Okay, for example, fish, we can say that. Next one, but there are the certain animals, that animals can live in water also and can survive on the land also, then that animals are called as what? Amphibians. Okay, then that animals are called as what? Amphibian, those who can live in water also and can survive on the land also, then that animals are called as amphibians. We can say the examples like frog, salamander, toad, all these are the examples for the amphibians. And the next one and the last one, that is what? Aerial. Okay, now what is mean by the aerial? The animals, those who are living in the air or spending their most of the lifespan on the in the air, then that animals are called as what? Aerial animal. Aerial means what? Those who are living in the air. For example, what? Yes, you are correct. What? Birds. Birds is the example for this aerial group. Okay, so on the basis of their habitat, what is mean by the habitat? It is the natural place where the animals are living. Okay, so the some animals are living on the land, some are living in the water, some are living on the both in the water also and on the land also, and some are living in the air. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the diversity and the classification of animals. The animals get classified on the basis of the cell, on the basis of the vertebral column, also on the basis of the feeding habits, also on the basis of the mode of the reproduction, and also on the basis of the habitat. Okay, so this is all about today. Today your homework is what? Whatever I have written on the board, that all the notes you have to write in your biology notebook. So here we will stop. We will meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.